Hello everyone, welcome back. One of my followers asked me to do a tutorial on how to stick these guitars on an object like what you see in the video right now. This is a description of the USD models that you can use. We are not using them in this tutorial. Instead, we are using these, the FBX. So make sure you get the correct one. I will be doing a tutorial on the USD very soon. Sketchfab here is where I got the model from, both of them. Some you have to pay for, some are free. This one here was the more difficult one that I showed you. I recommend avoiding this one to get used to doing it. I'm going to be doing the next tutorial on the USD models that are out. It's done completely different. You got to use the U nodes and some of the regular 3D. But for now, I would just try to stick with the FBX because that's what this tutorial is based on. Here's the one I use for the tutorial. And I selected the FBX. Like I said, next one will be on the USD. The link for this will be down in the description below. All you gotta do in the search, once you get here, is type in whatever you're looking for. Guitars, put that in, and they'll come out. And I have on a timeline a 20-second clip. I'm not gonna stabilize it. I'm gonna leave it the way it is, just for the tutorial. If you do want to stabilize it, you do it right here. And also, I'm pretty sure this is on the studio version only. This whole tutorial might be. Just go ahead and click on stabilize and then it'll calm the video right down. I have to use this on-screen keyboard because I'm paralyzed. Can I use my hands and arms? So it will be up there. We gotta convert our normal clip into a fusion clip. Right click on it, go up to new fusion clip. And go to Fusion. Click away right about here. Shift space. And camera tracker. Pipe that in like that. Go to dual viewers. The camera tracker in viewer one. I like to take these two sliders, move the detection threshold to the right a little bit. Something like that. Play around with them to get your best track. It's like bi-directional tracking, so it tracks both ways. And hit track. Now there's four different colors of the tracking markers. Blue and green are good. Yellow and red are not so good. Once it's done tracking, go up here to solve. Actually, let's go to the camera first. If you have the focal length and all the information for your camera, makes it much easier to find that object, the 3D object you're putting in the scene. We don't know that, so we're gonna have to do it the hard way. Now go to solve. And select solve right here. This will take quite a while sometimes. If it stays right on 99%, doesn't go anywhere, just wait it out, it will finish. It can take extremely long sometimes. Okay, it's done solving. This number right here, you want that to be below 1. Right now we're over 2. I understand if it's 4K footage, up to 1 is okay. 1080 they're saying, from what I understand, 0.5. But you're not going to get it right on the money either way. So we have to kill a bunch of these no good ones off so they can maximum track error. And only go a little bit at a time. If you go too far, you can lose all your tracks altogether. Here's the information, what we're doing here right now at the bottom. Select delete and solve again till we get that number below one. There are several ways of doing this tracking, this camera tracking. I found this to be what's working best for me. I know there's many other ways of doing it. I don't think there's really a right and a wrong way, to be honest. But other ways I've tried did not work. This seems to work for me. Okay, we're well below one now, so we're good there. Go to export. Initially, you're going to want to hit the export button, but don't do that yet. Select this 3D scene. This basically sets everything to where we're going to select here in a moment. Select unaligned. Go to one viewer. Highlight them. This here, we're going to change it from a ground plane to a wall because we're vertical. And then export. Now you'll see down in the notepad, we have a bunch of extra nodes. Cut that original line and connect that to there. We don't really need this camera tracker anymore, so you can delete it if you'd like to. I just leave it there. Now I'm going to get my model. Go to Fusion. Import FBX scene. And when you click on it, it'll open up like this. You have other options you can select if you want to, but I just leave it the way it is. Again, there are much more difficult models out there than what I selected for the tutorial here. Go to dual viewers again. Put the guitar texture in viewer one. I have to navigate around the 3D different than you guys. I don't have a middle mouse wheel, so you'll see that drop down menu all the time. I like to line these pivot points up before I even get started. So go over to transform. Select pivot. And these X, Y, and Z are not always X, Y, and Z. For whatever reason, they're different for the most part, but they're always different every time you put one in. So you just have to play around with the dials until you get it to go where you want it to go. Set them back to zero and close your pivot window. Now let's do the transform. Put the transform in viewer one. I'm not sure how much of an effect this actually has on it, but it seems to be easier to find the guitar if I line these pivots up and adjust it. And make sure you close the pivot window so we don't accidentally readjust them. Put the merge in viewer one. Now comes the hard part, trying to find your guitar or whatever object you use. If you look real close in viewer one, you'll see the image playing back there. Select on that ground plane. Here we go. Go back to the guitar. That's the one we're going to adjust everything on and scale it up. Go back to viewer two. You may have to change the fraction and the scale. See, normally the X is left and right, but now it's up and down. Yours may be different. And the Y is left and right instead of up and down. Like I say, you just have to play with them to figure them out. Something like that. Select this transform here and get a 3D merge. Highlight everything I did, right click and go up to copy. Click away down here, right click and paste. Connect that one into the merge. Select the guitar. Go to the inspector under transform. Should be our Y-axis, if I'm not mistaken. Again, if you cannot find a guitar, once you put all the nodes in, look behind the screen in the 3D, it could be anywhere. Now to get the perspective right, we want to downsize this one. You want to find a point, something like here. Line up with the line here, over on this side. That actually looks pretty good. Select this camera track and select lighting and shadows. Now if you look in the viewer, you'll see we don't have any light on the guitars. Click away right about here. Shift space. And directional light. And if you select that node, you can adjust the intensity. Right now, the light is right where the camera is, which is a pretty good spot for it. Using the target is not effective here. Actually makes it worse. We'll go up to the edit page, see how it looks. I see right now the guitar on the left needs to come down some. I think that looks a little better. For the sake of the tutorial, I'm just gonna leave it at that. More time you spend on it, the better you make it look. Okay, there's one thing I almost forgot. I cannot see it in this one. A lot of times you can see the ground plane. If you do, and you might want to do this anyways, select the ground plane node. Go to controls. Visibility. And uncheck it. Now it'll be gone. I am going to do another one that is completely different than this, with the guitar behind some buildings in the city and moving. So there'll be two different ways of doing it. I want to take a moment and show you a much more complex model than what we're using in this tutorial, so you know what to look for. As you see, this example has different guitars. I'm going to show you the difference on the complexity of the different models that you choose. And you're gonna see the one I use in this tutorial is much smaller. I had to add the chrome, and these here are the shaders I had to add to it. Most of these FBX already baked in, but some of these are not. And of course I had to copy. This was one. This is the second copy to put on the other pillar. But this is all put together by the model. This is all the same. Connects the same, but you have to add some shaders to it. Well, there you go. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.